The conclusions given at the end of the previous video can be confirmed by many other experiments. Let's place an electron in a strong homogeneous magnetic field. Initially, its spin can be oriented in any direction. The spin will perform precession. Classical analog of this effect is the precession of the angular momentum vector of a gyroscope in a gravitational field. But due to the energy considerations, the spin prefers to be oriented along the field lines. Therefore, eventually, spin will be pointing in the direction matching the direction of a magnetic field lines. The difference in energies between the initial and the final states of the spin will be released in the form of radiation, a photon. If a spin were a classical vector, it would be right to assume that the amount of emitted energy depends on the initial direction of the spin. If the spin were oriented along the field lines, then the energy would not be released at all. If the spin were directed in the opposite direction, then the maximum amount of energy would be released. At other orientations, some intermediate amount of energy would be released. But this does not happen. For a given external magnetic field, the energy of an emitted photon is always the same. Let's place a few electrons in a magnetic field and wait for their spins to align with the direction of the field lines. Then quickly change the direction of the external magnetic field. The electrons will suddenly find themselves in a high energy state, pointing in the direction against the field lines. Therefore, after a while, they will line up along the field lines, reducing their energy, which will leave the system in the form of a photon. Thus, the energy of the emitted photon is equal to the work required for changing the spin orientation from up to down, or vice versa. It's interesting to see what happens if you turn the magnet not only by 180 degrees, but by 90 degrees. After some time, the spins will align along the field lines in the direction of the x-axis. But the photon will be emitted only by half of the electrons. Moreover, the energy of each of the emitted photons will be the same as in the previous case, when changing the spin orientation from the spin-up state to the spin-down state. How can we interpret this? We can say that the spins of the electrons which emitted a photon were directed down the x-axis, that is to the left, and the spins of the electrons that did not emit a photon were directed upward along the x-axis, to the right. After all, as we have just seen, the energy of the emitted photon is the energy needed for turning the spin from the state down to the state up. It could not be directed anywhere else, according to the energy conservation law. It turns out that for half of the electrons with spin down relative to the z-axis, the spin was also directed down along the x-axis, and for the other half it was up along the x-axis. The situation is analogous to the one discussed in the previous video, where we use different method of spin measurement. Since the number of photon is the intensity of the radiation, the average amount of emitted energy is twice less. So by averaging, we reproduce the results of classical physics. Again, we also saw this earlier when we analyzed the Stern-Gerlach experiments. If we turn the magnet back to its original state, then again 50% of the electrons will emit a photon, but not necessarily the same ones that emitted it at the first time. That will be completely random electrons again. The spin measurement along one axis makes irrelevant previous information about the direction of spin along the other axis. After the measurement with respect to the x-axis, the electrons forget that they ever had their spins oriented along the z-axis. This rule is universal and does not depend on the particular method of spin measurement. Actually, it applies to all physical quantities, not only the spin. The process of measurement updates the information we have about the system. When the magnet is rotated at a random angle, the ratio of electrons emitting and not emitting a photon will change, and the ratio depends on that angle. But it is impossible in principle to predict the direction of spin of a particular electron after the rotation of the magnet. Or in other words, to know whether it will emit a photon or not. In classical physics, the number of photons corresponds to the intensity of electromagnetic wave. When averaged over a large number of electrons, the intensity of the emitted radiation smoothly changes from zero to a maximum when we rotate the magnet. The exact formula can be obtained using the mathematics of quantum mechanics.